You absolutely need to treat the water in your outdoor furnace. We recommend and use MolyArmor 350. It coats the metal with a layer of protectant. MolyArmor 350 is an excellent corrosion inhibitor. It's a molybdate inhibitor, and we like it because it's so easy to use. It's a foolproof water treatment. Treating your furnace water is simple. Add the proper amount of MolyArmor 350 through the top of the furnace vent tube before adding water. Now, how much, you may ask? Well, we have this handy chart here showing how many gallons of treatment your furnace model typically needs. 1 gallon of MolyArmor 350 corrosion inhibitor treats 200 gallons of system water. So after the system is circulated for about 24 hours, you need to make sure you have 350 parts per million. The way you do that is with these test strips. Notice there is an expiration date printed on the bottle. Take out one of the test strips and dip it in a water sample, and you're gonna compare it on the chart. You wanna have at least 350 parts per million. Now, if you have more than that, it's okay. It doesn't make any difference. You really can't add too much of MolyArmor 350. It's a wonderful product. Some of you who have been with us for a while may be wondering, what about the 1650 Corrosion Inhibitor Plus? For many years, we used 1650 XL Corrosion Inhibitor Plus. It's a nitrite-based inhibitor, and it's very good. Later on, we used this in conjunction with the Moly Boost, which provided even better protection. Now, this, or a combination of this, is a great protective corrosion inhibitor, as long as your nitrites are between 1,500 and 3,000 parts per million. You're okay, you're fine. However, if you test your water and your parts per million of nitrite are below 1,500, then what you need to do is drain your system, add in MolyArmor 350. The reason we switched to MolyArmor 350 had nothing to do with protection. They're both excellent corrosion inhibitors. However, MolyArmor 350 does offer some advantages. It's not subject to biological depletion. Also, with MolyArmor 350, you can't add in too much. If you put in double the amount, or whatever it might be, it's not a big deal. It doesn't matter. And the third one is that it's easier to test. This is an addendum for those of you who have used 1650XL Corrosion Inhibitor Plus in the past. First question, do I need to drain the system before adding in MolyArmor 350? Answer, no. There is no problem mixing in MolyArmor 350 on top of the Corrosion Inhibitor Plus. You can do that. However, if your water is discolored orange or brown and or your corrosion inhibitor parts per million is below 1,500, likely there's some corrosion going on in the water jacket, and it is best if you do drain the system. Get a jug of sludge conditioner and follow the directions in your owner's manual on how to flush it correctly. Next question. What about if I have antifreeze in my system? Well, no doubt it's a propylene glycol antifreeze. The nice part is everything's the same. This video applies to that as well. You can add in MolyArmor 350, and the nice part is now this test works equally as well for the antifreeze. Another question. MolyBoost, MolyArmor 350, are they the same thing? No, they are not. The key to this lies in the title, MolyBoost. Boost. This is like a booster for the Inhibitor Plus. This is a different product. So you need to add in the full and proper amount of MolyArmor 350, nothing else. If you have questions or need additional product, please contact your local Central Boiler dealer. You can find them by going to centralboiler.com or just call the guy you bought the wood furnace from.